This is an example of not keeping shearing records when you're an Angora rabbit breeder who's breeding for wool. So if you're a breeder and you have Angora rabbits and you want to breed for wool production, if you do not keep records, or if you do not keep consistent records, this is what you're doing. You're literally taking profit, you're literally taking money, and you are setting it on fire. And most rabbit breeders I know, most Angora rabbit breeders, they don't want to do this. They're not trying to take their profits and burn them up. But one of the things that's necessary is understanding and keeping proper wool records of your Angora rabbit. Now, the truth is, one of the reasons why it is so incredibly difficult is because there wasn't a good system. There wasn't a good way of keeping actual records for your rabbit. And if you can't just burn $100 bills, then use this. This is the Angora Rabbit Shearing Record. It's available in paperback, and it's available, you can go and get an ebook copy, but really, truthfully, the paper book is the best. And the paperback is the best. Literally, you can write your rabbit's name right here. So if I wanted to keep this shearing record for Arthur, what I would do is I would write Arthur's name right here. That way you know exactly who it is. And you can also write in here, Angora Rabbit Shearing Record of. So you have all the information. This is just a version of it. You have all the information of the rabbit, the birthday, the breed, the tattoo number, microchip number, the color, the genotype, all the important things that people want to know. And then this is just a brief look. You have your shearing date, you have your total wool weight. There's quite a few pages where you can do that. And then it goes into something amazing. The actual details of each shearing date. You have all the things that people want to know. And this is the cool thing, that if you are breeding for wool production, you need something where you can actually show people, and you need a method that if you want, you can have this go with the rabbit you sell. So for example, if it's a 1-year-old rabbit and you've shorn the rabbit 4 times, you have all 4 records in this book, it goes with the rabbit, and you have the evidence of the wool weight, the evidence that the rabbit can produce. And so if you're also breeding, you can keep the parent's record. There's pieces of burnt money now everywhere. But anyways, you can keep the parent's records and you can refer back to them that potential buyers want to know. You can charge more when you have detailed information, such as everything that's contained in the Angora Rabbit Shearing Record. You can use this for every single breed of rabbit that has wool on it. This is set up if you have a German, perfect. If you have a mixed breed, perfect. If you have a satin Angora, a French Angora, an English Angora, if you have a fuzzy lap and you're breeding for a wool, if you have a Jersey woolly and you're breeding for a wool, if you have any type, a giant Angora, this is set up and it literally has the information that you need that's important. Even more, there's information for the actual owner. Were there any concerns? And there's a record of treatments provided at shearing. Everything you can keep in this. So this book is available for $9.99. You can go to Amazon.com and pick up and order your paperback copy of this. It's priced incredibly inexpensive, $9.99 per rabbit. And you literally get to improve your breeding. You get to improve your rabbitry record keeping just from this. Bye-bye.